thoughts on these teams here, Wolf and Mirko. Right now, what I feel like is going to happen is for the side of Onyx, they really need to look for the snowball. CW getting the lead in that gold lane, getting the turrets done, and instantly swapping their lanes to control the neutral objectives. For Blacklist, it's a little bit of a brawl. Well, what about you, Wolf?
I think that it's easy for me to say that it's going to be Blacklist to take this one because this is very standard. As I'm looking at their heroes, pretty normal, like I said. Right, that's the expression that we're looking for, and that's the expression that fits this one. Oh. However, Onyx Indonesia might be prepared for this, but you can never really go wrong if you're going for Blacklist International.
Well, that's true. Is it going to be standard? Is it going to be preparation? One way to find out. It's Onyx versus Blacklist International in a best of three. Let's play this one out. Edward as well as Boots just taking their time. Boots doing a really good job overall, winning his trades against Edward and trying to zone him off of the wave.
Yeah, the main reason why I prefer on an esports draft over to Blacklist International. Sure, Blacklist did get their comfort picks, yes. But what you need to put into this game is those winning lanes, man. Firstly, that top side, 100% guaranteed to win the lane, all right? Uranus will not be able to be a threat up until he gets through those power spikes, and that's a little bit late to the game. Secondly, you already have such an aggressive jungler in the Pokito. Sure, it can be nullified by the Barretts, but with the side lane pressure coming in by that pop ball and the Hylos, additionally also the kill pressure from the Selena, I feel like they can control the map much easily.
Speaking of kill pressure here, CW getting good trades against Oheb. His Oh My Venus is going to back him up, and they're going to fully commit on towards CW here. Who's going to get the first blood? Popo and Koopa at a trade against each other. Keyboy manages to get there in time. That's going to be a Razor. First blood going in for Onyx Esports here. Oh My Venus taking a good... Oh, is that going to kill? Goodness. Oh, yes! It's Keyboy who pulls it off.
You can see CW picking up the Weapon Master, and he manned up against both Oh My Venus as well as Oheb. The idea is you always just poke out the Beatrix and you're gonna have a better matchup. Also, he flickered to the north, and I love that play coming up from CW, outplaying two of the members of Blacklist International. Surely he died, but he was still alive when Oheb fell.
Yeah, and what we need to take into account for is the wave, right? The wave was really good for Onyx Esports. They were able to zone away the members. And again, it's going to be Oheb bullied, shut down in the early stages, just like the keys to victory. And look at what CW is doing, using that. And look!
Oh my Venus, he's getting punished here. Oh, but he manages to stop Drian's Feather Airstrike just in time. Nice play from Haji, saving Oh My Venus. You don't see that happening too often, but Blacklist plays very tightly together.
Look at this. Outer turret energy shields out as well as what? 30% HP left on the turret in the bottom lane. That play coming out from Sans. Yes, he wasn't able to secure the turtle for Onyx Esports, but they have secured a turret at 2 minutes and 45 seconds with just a trade. Oh my god, macro plays, man.
Really, really good. They're just abusing the fact that, you know, Popo and Koopa just likes to hit turrets.
Yeah, this is what I said, all right? On Esports, I've seen them play this so many times in MPL ID, and this is exactly what they like to do. Look at where the Popo and Koopa is going. Right after they get the turret in the bottom side, sure, go and get your neutral objectives. We'll get pressure on the map, so the later neutral objectives will be all controlled by us. The side lane is the name of the game, and with these heroes, like the Uranus, it is gonna just completely get bullied out.
Oh, look at this lane switch from Onyx very early on, but they want to really push and maybe get some gold into Boots and some EXP to CW, as right now CW doesn't even need more gold because he already got a turret for himself.
Mm-hmm. So far, it feels like Onyx Esports is just a little bit ahead of the motions. They know what Blacklist wants to do, and they're taking preemptive measures here. Abyssal Arrow does land on Oh My Venus, but Nibiru's Passion going to zone them away. Keyboy losing 50% of his HP, but here comes the rest of the squad. Bakito and Farsa very nearby here. CW taking good bit of damage, but there is no wave to continue on this dive.
Interesting to see that the Selena was last picked by the side of Onyx Esports after the fact that they already saw the Barretts as well as the Rafaela. Normally, well, at least before, we see the Selena being first picked by teams and answered by a Barretts as well as the Rafaela. The Barretts being having the resilience from the big guy makes it so that you can tank up the arrow, as well as the Rafaela healing any arrow target so that when the team that picked up the Selena overcommits, they can easily punish. Onyx Esports still pick up the Selena despite the fact, and that makes it this draft so interesting. So far, so good though for Keyboy.
Adaptations are being made here as Blacklist International looking to try to get on top of this turtle, but so far they're just waiting for Onyx to get priority first. They need to have that vision. Feather Airstrike coming on towards Haji's side, but he manages to stop Dream, brooding him down with the Yin Yang over there and 50% HP. Glorious Pathway going to be locked down with the Law and Order. Haji is already down, and Oh My Venus might be next on that chopping block is wise. And Edward chasing Sands down, and there they go. They find Oh My Venus. Daytona's Welcome doesn't land on anybody. Boots manages to flicker out just in time. Oh, that's going to be an abyssal arrow on towards Edwards here. Does he have the concentration? No, he does not. He might be in a little bit of trouble here, but can he take out Keyboy just in time? No, Keyboy makes sure that Wise is hit by the abyssal arrow, and now the backup is here. Drian with the feathered air strike and a zone off doesn't pick up the kill.
Wait. Look at the mid lane. Onyx Esports already took down the turret. That is how quick you blink and you lose your turrets. Blade of Despair now picked up with the Weapon Master and GWS. There will be a kill in the mid lane. You cannot let go of the map if you're Blacklist International. Don't overcommit to fights. Don't be overcommitted to your sustain, because if you blink, you're gonna lose turrets.
Yeah, and this is exactly what I said. On Esports, they went to the bottom side. They got the turret done, right? Turret is down on the bottom side, so the push is gonna be much more in favor of On Esports. They get the pressure in that bottom side, goes to the turtle, uses the turtle as a distraction, and just scrambles it away. You can see Blacklist, they wanted to group, but what did On do? They made it. They isolated the members via the map pressure they put onto the map, and look how they're playing it again. Blacklist, they're getting caught out every place, every single lane.
Mm-hmm. Yep, they're trying to defend as much as they can. And I mean, so far, it feels like Blacklist in for... Oh no, Sats! Is he gonna get it? Wise manages to get the Daytona's welcome just in time. He should be able to walk away from this, but Sats, he's not happy with this. He's gonna fully commit the amount of time enough for the cooldowns to come back off.
Three turrets for Arnik Esports. I'm really just surprised at Blacklist International. Before that play, they were actually closing in the gold, and there's not much that Arnik Esports were able to build despite them getting three turrets. But now, it has changed. Arnik Esports, with all of the tier 1 turrets down, this just means that they will have more map control, particularly in that mid lane. Losing that mid lane tier 1, it's really not that good for Blacklist International.
I mean, look at the momentum coming out from Arnik, their objective plays, and now we're going to be looking over towards turtle side to see whether Blacklist International actually want to commit to this or just let this go. They have to make a decision now.
The thing is, for Blacklist, is that they literally don't have pressure all anywhere on the map. The bottom side is going to be in favor of On Esports, top side as well, and the side laners. Like this, you see, they try to open up the map.
Yep, and Oh My Venus, there's nothing much he can do. He's dependent on his tanks to walk up into the wards, the brushes, but that does mean that Feather Airstrike has already been coming out from Gian and Sans. I mean, you know, it's Bakito. As they all start moving forward here, Abyssal Arrow coming through, nobody gets hit so far, but a breaking dig off a turn coming in from Haji Combo with Nibiru. Passion, they bail out with a glorious pathway and turtle going over to Blacklist International. The plays have been made. Turtle slain by STB. Daytona's welcome going to be locking on towards Sands. Here he goes down.
Oh, and that's exactly why Blacklist are so scary. You can get the lead, but they are just so composed. They know how to play the game, and they're going to force their play style onto you.
You see that? It's falling like dominoes now for Arnik Esports. They have lost two of their members with a wonderful initiation coming out from Haji. Touted as the MVP machine already, formerly known as the KDA machine, now is the MVP machine. So far, has been really good for Blacklist International. You see, Arnik Esports, they just lost one fight, and then eventually they lost Sans. They lost two buffs in their own side of the jungle, as well as a mid lane turret. Now, Blacklist International in the lead.
1,500 gold lead for Onyx. Nope, it's 1,500 gold lead for Blacklist instantly after one fight, turning the entire gold lead around. But Onyx, they do still have some things to play for, all right? The thing is, for them, I mentioned it before, they are a very snowball composition. If they don't get that snowball, honestly, Blacklist International, they can't just keep on looking for these fights. Onyx, what they need to do right now is isolate Blacklist International. Again, these heroes are not good for the all-out team fight. You have the Selena, you have that Popo and Koopa. Use your strength, split up the map, and get the picks.
Completely agree with you on that one, as Blacklist International clearly is the better team at team fights. Not only with their draft, but with their execution as well. You saw how well they maintained their position despite them like losing parts of the map, and they have real focus on these objectives. So far, three turtles going in favor of Blacklist International. Three turrets as well. They have equalized already. And whatever Onyx Esports built in the early stages, it's all down the drain.
Well, speaking of which, Keyboy losing his position, allowing Blacklist International sit on top of turtle. Is Onyx Esports going to contest?
It is the lore this time. It seems like just with the positioning of the members of Onyx Esports, not likely for them to contest. Well, it's just the level one lore anyways. Not much that they will lose if they do give it up. But at the same time, they just need to farm up right now. I wonder what they're waiting for. Maybe Maybe the Winter Truncheons on their mages.
I mean, they don't have to, but we're looking at the adaptation coming in from Onyx Esports. They make the decision to get a split push and get a tier 2 down on that bottom side as Turtle has fallen.
It's an okay trade. Definitely better for Blacklist International, but at that point, Onyx, they really can't go for these contests. Again, Blacklist with their composition, they are going to be able to dominate every single neutral objective, and they need to be careful right now. But Onyx, they are still pulling the punches and going in. That's half HP taken out of Oheb.
Yeah, I mean, but there's no real commitment. They're just waiting for the Lord. If they fight now, it's really not going to mean much and could hurt Onyx Esports more than it should.
I was actually surprised the Blacklist International did not get the kill onto CW. If I was looking just at the minimap, the pincer maneuver was already perfect, but I guess with Sans just positioning himself well, he helped CW get out. He did commit the flicker, but at the same time, he got a farm in the bottom lane anyway, so all is good for Arctic Esports for now. They still will be, it will still be super difficult for them to defend against this first Lurk push against Blacklist International if they miss out. But then again, they have this Farsa. If Drian isn't as smart as he is, this will be an easy push for Blacklist International.
Well, speaking of which, Omega Venus is going to take the Abyssal Arrow here. They're looking for something in Daytona's Walk. He can't get onto Boots. No, it doesn't land just yet, as the rest of Omnic is going to start backing away, looking for space. It's going to hit on towards Edward here, but so far, coming in, Renner is doing some good work. Lord is trying to crash on through. If they can get an inhibitor, this would be a big win for Blacklist International as they continue the siege. It's not exactly going into anybody's favor. The Yin Yang Overturn, all the ultimates have been wasted here. No inhibitor turns at all for Blacklist International as they will break another tier 2 down on mid side.
Hey, that's huge.
That's huge. Two tier 2s in exchange for the Lord might be three tier 2s, and that's a lot of economical damage that they're able to give to Onyx Esports.
And the thing is, right now for Blacklist International, what they need to do is, again, just clump up to five, just push every single side lane, and that's going to be GG easy. Onyx, they really have the harder win condition to follow through here in the late stages of the game. You need to get them to, you need to be able to isolate Blacklist, but at this point, they don't need to be isolated at all.
Well, Blacklist International, the classic ultimate bonding experience, we see them. I always say that the UBE time, or the UBE time, is always around the 7-minute mark, and boy did we see that in the mid lane fight. If we look back 5 minutes before, that was the fight that they were able to win, and eventually they took over. You see them really take advantage of when they group up. They punish heavily when their opponents slip up, and Onyx Esports had a major slip up in that mid lane. However though,
speaking of slip ups, Edward's now in some trouble. Ooh, the concentration! Is this magic worship gonna kill him? No, he manages to survive through all that damage. That's really nice as Wise gets hit by the Abyss Arrow, they steal away the purple buff, and things are all fine and dandy, except this Daytona's Welcome is going to connect on towards Hylos here. It's going to be the drive attribution, going to be dropped down to slow things over. The Holy Healing can only do so much as the Beer's Passion tries to push him away. Edward manages to get on out of there. Boots is going to be on the chopping block instead.
That was beautiful by Blacklist International. It looked so good for Onyx up to a certain point where Boots was the target. Blacklist used all, and I really mean all, the resources onto him. But Onyx, they didn't pull the trigger. They were scared. They didn't have the resources to come back from that fight. And the Feather Airstrike was already used way too early in the fight. And that is the reason Blacklist went in, but Edward!
No, he already goes down to the wards of Feathered Airstrike. You don't want to see that, but they still trade Edward for an inhibitor. At least they got something despite not having a Lord at that time.
Back-to-back skirmishes, we saw Ohem really stepping up. He was the one to take out the turret and also was the one to snipe Boots when he was trying to run away with that ultimate. Really on point with this sniper, this Renner coming out from Beatrix. And Onyx Esports, they did surprise Edward, who dashed in and really just took that arrow coming up from Keyboy. But that wasn't enough for Onyx Esports to defend their inhibitor up top. The second Lord, the Enhanced Lord, that's the most important thing, and they want to take advantage of Edward not being here yet.
I mean, they've got some form of position. It's a little 50-50. Is Blacklist starting to exert their more pressure towards the mid turret, the mid brush here so far? It's a nerve-wracking situation, and both sides just holding on strong. Blacklist still with a very clear lead, but more importantly, they're at the 42k mark. They have an item power spike for their carries.
Exactly.
Onyx is respecting that so far. And we're going to be clashing against Boots so far.
Sans is too far.
He's too far. He really can't do much. But now they've got the Feathered Airstrike onto multiple targets. Lord has been taken away by Blacklist International. Boots. Killing spree coming in. But Boots, he's trying his absolute best here. It's going to be Drian finding the kill onto what's Wise, as the rest of the team is going to be chasing down the Onyx members one by by one. Edward doing a good job at splitting up this fight, but he's just way too tanky. And again, tank problems front to front, like Miracle said.
Yeah, this is the problem for Onyx Esports. The reason being, like how Blacklist International were able to win these fights is because of that Uranus. Now, we said it before, Uranus in the early stages very easy to just take him down and shut him down. But in these late stages, he becomes an absolute monster, and the front line is just too tanky, too sustainable for Onyx to melt.
Yeah, Haji has his eyes on Dree and Yin Yang overturn already popped to try and one shot him.
Oh my goodness, you can see that with Blacklist International, just Haji focusing on canceling that feather. There's like, be a defense from Onyx Esports, but boy oh boy, Blacklist International did take advantage once again. As Onyx Esports were kind of disconnected in that Lord retake. We're trying to go for a steal, but Sans was far too far away. And Blacklist International actually identified that Sans was not in the vicinity. That's why they rushed through the Lord.
Makes sense here. As Dream once again getting hit by the Yin Yang overturn, getting cast against one shot this time by Haji. It's going to be wise, but the Holy Healing is going to allow them to stay topped off here. Ooh, this is so brutal as Onyx Esports, what looked to be a good initial fight in the early game, now struggling to come back here at the later stages.
Oh boy, he feels that he can get a kill at the off. In fact, he does, if he does lance the stun, but oh, we're ready with the immortality. This is going to be massive for Blacklist.
Yep, they're going to be taking their last inhibitor here. Edward absorbing the damage. But CW taking a huge chunk. Haji wants to take him out. No Yin Yang overturn this time around. Nibiru's passion comes on through to take out Selena. But Wise, unfortunately, not able to get the Daytona's welcome off on towards any targets.
This is insane. The defense and the aggression from Blacklist International. It doesn't even feel like a 7,000 gold lead at that fight, right? Sure, the map shows that a 7,000 gold lead is present, but that team fight right there, honestly, I'm surprised that Onyx is able to defend that. That was a very good siege, and they've already lost their high ground potential in Drian. Now, let's take a look at the items. Let's slow it down a little bit. What happened in this few minutes, the 7,000 gold lead, what has Blacklist been able to get?
Well, they did have so much tankiness on Edward as well as Wise. Look at their item pickups. They're very, very tanky. And you can see that Edward really just focused on all defensive items, just the Enchanted Tasman. And look at Oheb with the Blade of Despair, the Demon Hunter Sword, as well as the Malefic Lord. The Sniper is just way too much for them to handle. And so far, Oheb has been on point with the ultimate of the Renner.
I mean, it's brutal to see, but yes, he's got to take advantage of the fact he's got so much damage and really needs to start targeting these squishier targets. Not to mention that Keyboy being overall, he's not even building defensively.
Yeah, the thing is, on the Selena, there's no real point of going for the defense, right? You gotta go full all out. That is a high risk, high reward hero. You picked it, you gotta go full in. You gotta commit onto it. Because right now, Boots, he is your main frontline. But do you see the damage coming in from that Beatrix? It absolutely just melts Boots away. This is a battle of the frontline. It's a front to back composition in this fight. But what Onyx really wants to do is pick. The thing is, when you have three inhibitor turrets have been taken down, you have no choice but to group up. And now they're going to go try to look for some picks on the map.
Well, the conceal has been popped as they look towards Edward. He's trying to get him out of there. He used the Purify very early on, as well as the concentration. He might be in trouble. He finally goes down. But Blacklist International, they're not going to make too many big moves here. Onyx, take the pick. Go back into base. 8 seconds for this Lord.
Ooh, the heist of Onyx Esports. Wait for the conceal play. It's actually pointed in the right direction. It's a very good setup, as now they will have a little bit of a breathing room. And this is also timed with the Lord spawn. So maybe that was the idea for Onyx Esports. You know, coincide that kill onto Edward, who has been split pushing into the Lord take. But Blacklist International still wants to fight this. They actually have full Lord, but they had to reset it. 17 seconds before Edward respawns. Maybe they have bought enough time.
Sans needs to take, I mean, Onyx, they need to commit onto this right now. This is the time. It's now or never. Remember, if Blacklist gets the Lord, it is going to be all over. Let's see what happens here, Gideon.
Yep, Feathered Airstrike has already been popped. It's gone. Cooldown so far. Edward still isn't here. It's Blacklist International playing this slow. Glorious Pathway already on. Boots is going to be right into the middle of the fight, flickering forward, but it's going to be unfortunately locked out. Daytona's welcome buying enough time, but Wise goes down in the process. They're going to be continuing their fight as Oheb has done a massive job here for the team. Haji going to be good. Drian in trouble, running away from Edward here, but Oheb, oh my goodness, unable to look for the target he wanted. Keyboy takes the damage.
Okay, so I'm gonna nerd out a bit here as Blacklist International is slowly taking the Lord. Oheb actually poked and focused onto that Koopa. And Onyx Esports had to spend 5 more seconds for Koopa to respawn. And Oheb actually knows that that CW was hiding in the bush. Pops his ultimate right before the 5 second mark so that the uptime for CW was really deterred. And that allowed Blacklist International to have a better move. However, Onyx Esports, great jump and great composure coming out from Boots, trusting his teammates to jump. Drian focused by Haji, but ultimately survives that. And this is like a mini battle between all of the laners, like the Gold Lane versus the Gold Lane, or versus CW, as well as Haji versus Drian, just trying to outplay each other. And it is a pretty even fight between these two teams.
The macro game has been insane. Yeah, have you seen Blacklist International? They've reset this Lord 3 times now because of the waves that Onyx has been able to control. Even without inhibitors, this is impressive, man. This is insane. How are they able to actually rotate and micromanage these waves so well in this situation with the Lord, with the pressure all on them, and Blacklist with the 3,000 gold lead? They're still able to withstand the pressure and once more coming in, opening up their into this Lord.
You know, speaking of which, the Feathered Airstrike as well as the Yin Yang Overturn have been used for Onyx Esports so far. Ooh. Nobody really wants to commit to this, and I guess they're just waiting for Boots to get his flicker back up before they engage. Ooh. I suppose.
Wise and Boots are just, there's a mini battle that's happening here.
Yeah.
The aggro of the Lord, man. I have to nerd out a bit if I were to explain it, but put simply, they're trying to, not for Blacklist International, they're trying not to reset the Lord. For Onyx, they specifically Boots, he wants to reset the Lord as soon as possible. CW already.
He's got hit by the Yin Yang Overturn this time. He's at 50% HP. Not exactly a comfortable position here. Why is going to get hit by the damage feather? It's going to be the Flame Shot that comes through, but hits Koopa. Drian has an interesting position here, but does have the Wings by Wings to get on out of there. Blacklist going to take priority over the Lord once again.
And I think that's it. I think the Lord is going to be taken away by Blacklist International. Look at CW. He was way too low. He now has to go and manage that top side. This is going to be either a steal or Blacklist just taking it all out. Boots wants to go in.
Daytona's Welcome going to be locking him and the time being here. The steal, it doesn't seem possible as Wise has already got the Retribution. Haji doing a great job getting on top of Keyboy so far. But that's going to be Winter's Trudging. Gets punished by Drea. Edward in the back line. Trying to make time, but CW actually makes it happen. He's doing it. Already taking all my Venus as well as Haji in the process.
Boots
very, very low, but Sans is going to keep Edward at bay. Lord falls into the hands of Blacklist International. Oh, and it's going to be Uranus that's going to take them down. A little sad to see, of course, but so far Edward continuing to be an absolute nuisance as Oheb is going to be walking up. Keyboy, unfortunately, taking a little bit of damage from Nibiru's Passion.
Oh, what the heck is going on? This is not supposed to happen, man. 3 inhibitor turrets down. Blacklist International marching into the base with the Enhanced Lord. I don't know what's going to happen. Let's just see.
Well, Ara does hit on Uranus so far. Keyboy so low! Dies over Godline coming in from Oheb, and now he's going to be taking out Sans as well.
That's
as Edward creates the space. They have done it. That's game number one. A triple kill for Oheb, cracking the crystal. GG. Well played for Blacklist International.
Calm, collected, and boom. There you have it, man. That was a beautiful, clinical by the side of Blacklist International. It looks so good for Onyx in the start, but Blacklist, they really know how to play to their game.
And Warren, as well as Oheb, stepping up. You saw how they were able to just maintain their composure. Oheb gets the triple in the end. He actually baited Edward in there because they know that if anybody gets picked by that arrow, you can just pop the Nibiru's Passion. So when anyone dives for that for the stun unit, they will be punished. That's exactly what happened. As much as Keyboy was able to get out, he got hit by the creeps, and the creeps already the enhanced minions, right? Because of the Lord fight, and of course, they took advantage, and Oheb really stepping up in that moment.